All right, this is the Big D Zone, and we are going to start off by saying this today is the Encourager Ministry Day. And, well, I finally went to church today. I went to New Beginnings and had a very good time. Although I had to wait because it was thunder and lightning earlier, so I didn't want to get drenched, but it stopped raining, so I was able to go to church. And, so I could be close to finally finding a new church home. So, I am honoring God today by playing gospel music, and also I'm going to be including a sermon by Billy Graham, or a program by Billy Graham called Lot to Lose, or Lose the Game. But anyway, it's all here on the Big D Zone, and here we go. And I stopped the play for a minute because it was on the wrong thing, so now we could play the whole show. This is the Big D Zone, and here we go.
Congress shall make no laws respecting an establishment of religion, or prohibiting the free exercise thereof, or abridging the freedom of speech, or of the press, or the right of the people peacefully to assemble and to petition the government for a redress of grievance.
Alright, we are live on the Andy Bounce Show and also on Broadsley FM. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Encourager Ministry portion of the Big D Zone. And some Sundays I think I'm going to do a gospel program where I'm not only going to include a sermon from a preacher, or maybe have guest preachers coming in on the program, but I'm going to feature gospel music as well. So just on a program note, tomorrow I have a guest on the Big D Zone. And the name of my guest will be Derek Williams. And he was going to tell you how you can get into the hair weave business, and you can make money doing that as well. So find out how you could be able to do that tomorrow on the Big D Zone. I'm going to be coming on anytime between 5 and 7, and I'm also going to play the interview on WBDR so I could go on to iHeartRadio. All my interviews will be going on iHeartRadio as well. And anyway, everything is working fine. No flood watch has the flood watch has come and gone, or so they say, or maybe it's tonight. I'm not even sure. But they said it was supposed to be all day and into tonight. But anyway, this is the home of the best fans. This is the Big D Nation. And this is the home of the Big D Zone. And I am Prince Big D. This is the Encourager Ministry.
But don't know where to go, don't know where to turn? Or do you have a product or service or an opportunity and you want to sell it to the citizens of Big D Nation? Now you can do it right here on the Big D Zone. Also, we can sell your items as we are on iHeart Radio Talk, and we are on stations in the UK. So ladies and gentlemen, there is a place that you can sell your items to. There is a place that you could do your advertising for a very low cost. And there is a discount plan for citizens of Big D Nation. So if you want to advertise on the Big D Zone, get in contact with me. Go to the Big D Zone or Deshaun.Porter Facebook page, or you can email me, DeshaunPorter1@gmail.com. That's DeshaunPorter1@gmail.com. Advertise your business, your book, your music, and also you can advertise your events on the Big D Zone.
By the eyes of the blind, in the middle of the night. In the middle of the night, I go walking in my sleep, through the desert of the truth, to the river so deep. We all land in the ocean, we all start in the streets, we're all carried along by the river of dreams. In the middle of the night, options of you. I'm trying to pray, but where are you? I'm all churched out, hurt and abused. I can't pray what's left to do. Truth is I'm weak, no strength to fight, no tears to cry, even if I tried, but still my soul refuses to die. Mm-hmm. One touch will change my life. Take me to the King. I don't have much to bring. My heart's torn in pieces. It's my offering. Lay me at the throne. Leave me there alone to gaze upon your glory and sing to you this song. Please take me to the King. Truth is, it's time to stop playing these games. We need a word for the people's name. So Lord, speak right now. Chasing after you. Oh, no rules, no religion. I've made my decision to run to you, the healer that I need. Take me to the King. Don't have much to bring. My heart's torn to pieces. It's my offering. Lay me at the throne. Leave me there alone to gaze upon your glory and to sing to you this song.
I don't have much to bring. My heart's torn to pieces. It's my offering.
I'd like to talk to you about getting on when things are not going quite so well. Like this morning, I woke up and I was real depressed, but something told me. You gotta keep on, keep it on. Like going on. Yeah.
That was the Mississippi Mass Choir, and Still Life Going On. And after the Dreams Motivation and the Free Pastor Shahid, now I've already signed my petition at Free Herb Project. I'm going to make a new promo. After that, it's going to be Friend of God, Israel Huntington, The Walls Group, Hold On, Mary Mary, Go Get It, The Miracle Wonders, and Billy Graham is going to be giving a special message.
You've been working toward that dream, but that dream that you're holding in your mind, that it's possible, that some of you already know that it's hard, it's not easy, it's hard changing your life, that in the process of working on your dreams, you are going to incur a lot of disappointment, a lot of failure, a lot of pain. There are moments when you're going to doubt yourself and say, God, why is this happening to me? I'm just trying to take care of my children and my mother. I'm not trying to steal or rob from anybody. Why does this have to happen to me? For those of you that have experienced some hardships, don't give up on your dream. Their rough times are going to come, but they have not come to stay. They have come to pass.
Greatness is not this wonderful, esoteric, elusive, godlike creature that only the special among us will ever taste. You know, it's something that truly exists in all of us.
It's very important for you to believe that you are the one. Most people, they raise a family, they earn a living, and then they die. They stop growing, they stop working on themselves, they stop stretching, they stop pushing themselves. That a lot of people like to complain, but they don't want to do anything about their situation. And most people don't work on their dreams. Why? One is because of fear. The fear of failure. What if things don't work out? And the fear of success. What if they do and I can't handle it? These are not risk takers.
You spend so much time with other people. You spend so much time trying to get people to like you. You know other people more than you know yourself. You studied them. You know about them. You want to hang out like them. You want to be just like them. And you know what? You've invested so much time in them, you don't know who you are. I challenge you to spend time by yourself.
That everybody won't see it. That everybody won't join you. That everybody won't have the vision. It's necessary to know that. That you are an uncommon breed. It's necessary that you align yourself with people and attract people in and into your business who are hungry. People who are unstoppable and unreasonable. People who are refusing to leave life just as it is and who want more. The people that are living the party winners to attach themselves to. The people that are living their dreams are the people that know that if it's going to happen, it's up to them.
If you want to be more successful, if you want to have and do stuff you ain't never done before, number two, I'm asking you to invest in you. To invest in you.
Someone's opinion of you does not have to become your reality. That you don't have to go through life being a victim. And even though you face disappointments, you have to know within yourself that I can do this. Even if no one else sees it for me, I must see it for myself.
Dead.
this is what I believe, and I'm willing to die for it. Period.
No matter how bad it is, or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it.
I want to represent an idea. I want to represent possibilities.
And some of you right now, you want to be, you know what I'm saying? You want to go to the next level. I want to counsel. You know, I want to be an engineer. I want to be a doctor. Listen to me. You can't get to that level. You can't get to the level economically where you want to be until you start investing in your mind. You're not reading books. I'm challenging y'all to go to conferences. I dare you to invest time. I dare you to be alone. I dare you to spend an hour getting to know yourself. When you become who you are, when you become the person that you were created to be, designed to be who you were designed to be, when you become an individual, what you do is you take yourself and you start separating yourself from other people. I tell you to get to a place where people don't like you, don't even bother you no more. Why? Because you're not concerned with trying to make them happy, because you're trying to walk, you're trying to get to the next level. I need you to invest in your mind, invest in your mind. If you still talk about your dream, if you still talk about your goal, but you have not done anything, just take the first step.
That you can make your parents proud, you can make your school proud, you can touch millions of people's lives, and the world will never be the same again because you came this way. Don't let nobody steal your dreams. After we face a rejection and a no, or we have a meeting and no one shows up, or somebody say, you can count on me, and they don't come through. What if we have that kind of attitude? The cause we possess, nobody believes in you. You've lost again and again and again. The lights are cut off, but you're still looking at your dream, reviewing it every day, and say to yourself, it's not over until I win. You can live your dream.
Hello, this is Prince Big D, and I am doing this promo to help out the family of Pastor Shahid. He is in an Iran prison, and he was starting an orphanage. He is a Christian missionary who loved the Lord dearly, and he's serving God, even in prison. He is serving an 8-year sentence in Iran. We need to get Pastor Shahid home. Even President Barack Obama at a prayer breakfast called for Pastor Shahid release. And also, Secretary of State John Kerry called for his release as well. We can all do our part. Not only we can pray for his release so that he could be back to his wife and children, but we could also sign the petition. If enough people sign this petition, then we could pressure Iran to release him, even in a good and humanitarian way. Go to this website and join me, and I'm going to be signing my name to this petition as well. Go to www.beheardproject.com. That's www.beheardproject.com, and help this man of God get back to his family where he belongs. I thank you.
You are mindful of me, that you hear me when I call. Is it true that you are thinking of me, how you love me? It's amazing, who am I, Lord?
Jesus, it's amazing. Thank you. a world yard. Somebody needs to know.
Get your blessing. Researcher Robert Goldman polled 198 world-class athletes asking, would you take a pill that would guarantee a gold medal even if you knew that it would kill you in 5 years? Do you know what the answer was? More than half said they'd do it. In other words, they want athletic success and they want that gold medal more than they want life itself.
I was 19, professional skateboarder. My name's on the skateboard, it's on shoes, it's on tech decks, it's on wheels, it's in all kinds of different games, and skateboard kids that are screaming at you, that are obsessing over you, that love the tricks you do, or love the team that you're with. I'm riding for Tony Hawk and the biggest companies in skateboarding. You do feel like you're on top of the world, and rightfully so. You know, you are accomplishing something.
Say it was me, because I want
it. It's a pretty phenomenal feeling.
On stage, and I tell this joke, and all these people laugh, like 400 people.
You wanted me to give them a 2 weeks notice. I was like, yo, boss, 2 weeks from now, you're going to notice I ain't been here in 2 weeks.
Strangers, black people, white people, women, kids, I have them all laugh.
And someone looks at me out of nowhere, and he just said to me, Dad, I want to be a doctor.
I was like, yes, yes, yes.
And he said, or a dinosaur.
I understood. This is what I'm going to do.
He was amazing, and he was in love with me. It was like being on cloud nine. It felt like we had so much in common, and I was just taken. I had found a guy that was beyond my wildest imagination. Everything I wanted in my life, he had.
I would give anything that I did. I'll hold on to it at all costs.
I feel this hot. It was just in me. It was awakening. It was stirring. And I want to do whatever I need to do to get it back.
I felt like I would do anything for him. Anything. And I just wanted to keep it, whatever that took.
Pursuing doing comedy, I'm having some success in the Midwest, and I feel like I need to test my skills in New York City. Because in New York, if you're not funny, the way they let you know is they say something like, you're not funny. So I'm moving to New York. So now I'm in New York, and I'm all about seeing what I can do to get my comedy career going. And the clubs in New York are really hard to get into. I finally got my chance to perform, and right before I go on stage, this comedian named George Wallace walks in. Now, George Wallace, I love him. Here's the problem, though. When someone like George Wallace walks in, whoever's next automatically gets bumped. The manager's walking over, and he says, Michael, listen, George Wallace is here. Would you like to go on before him or after him? George Wallace. I do my comedy set. I've got New Yorkers laughing. And then George Wallace starts to laugh. And then he comes over to me and he says to me, you know, you're really funny. And he invites me to do a show with him and his best friend. I get to the club and he tells me his best friend is Jerry Seinfeld.
I got in so many fights as a kid, it was maybe out of fear that something bad was going to happen, and skating was the way out for me. You fast forward a bit, there I am, I'm 15, I've been skating a few years, I've won contests. I get a phone call from my friend who lives in America, who wants me to come over and ride for one of the companies there. This is one of the first skate movies I was really in. It was over $1 million to make. Tony Hawk tour. We just show up at the skate park and the whole town would call everyone. It would be on the TV and all different places. This was pretty big. By the age of 19, I'd fallen in love with an American girl and asked her to marry me. We just were so in love, we just started putting everything together, Polaroids, writing about our life. It was just all lovey-dovey. I've never had to work to begin with, and now there's, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars coming in a year. I'd be on these tours, it was all about you. I mean, kids had your hair cut, they had your pants, life was good.
Dad? I actually can't remember a time in my life when my dad was consistently around. Every time my dad would see me, he would say things like, I feel like you've grown up so much, and it would just sting, because I always felt like he shouldn't be here as it's happening. So I'm living in New York now, and I was wondering, would you maybe want to come visit? It was really lonely. So I looked for attention from guys. And so I just jumped from like serious relationship to serious relationship. Finally, when I was a senior, I met this guy that swept me off my feet. He was amazing. Here we go. He had written a book, and he was a professional dancer, and he owned a business, and we both loved Great Laffy Taffy, which, hey, whatever. I was thrilled. I thought I had found the love that I'd always been looking for, you know? And it felt like, you know, my epic love story. So, we were engaged after 3 months. What I didn't know when I first met him, though, was that the one thing that I thought was going to bring me happiness was actually just making me miserable.
Where is peace? Where is fulfillment? Where is life's purpose and meaning? How many of you are crying tonight on the inside? On the outside, you have a mask. Inside, the peace and the joy and the happiness that you've always searched for is missing. You see, the whole country is on a quest for something. In drugs, in sex, in entertainment, we want something. We don't quite know what it is. And it's elusive. We don't find it. All of a sudden, in the midst of a crowd, in the midst of a dance, in the midst of a band playing, your face will suddenly have a little cloud over it, just for an instant. It's just a moment in which it seems that it's not all put together. The puzzle is not put together. And then you forget to go on. But it's there, and it'll grow through the years.
So here I am. I'm about to hit the stage with George Wallace and Jerry Seinfeld. My uncle was really cheap. Man, he was cheap. He bought me an action figure, right? That's what he said it was. I opened up the box and it's empty. You talking about that's Invisible Man. I played with it for like 2 weeks, man. And I lost it. I do two shows and I get two standing ovations. I'll rip. Things are starting to happen for me in New York. There still is more. I'm funny. I can make a room of 1,000 people laugh. And then what? Am I only here to make people laugh?
We go on in our pleasures, thinking they're going to last forever. But they don't.
I really thought that I was a good person. I didn't smoke, I didn't drink, I didn't do any of those things. And it gave me a false sense of me being okay. The truth is I was just as lost as the person who was using drugs every day. I had tried so many things the way that I wanted to do it. I knew there had to be a better way. I walk into this church, and this guy's up on stage, and he's talking about Jesus. I said, he's just talking about Jesus. He's not screaming, he's not angry, he's not yelling. I don't got no towel, he's just talking about this guy named Jesus in a way that I can understand. Life was bigger than just me. It's so not just about me and what I can get. So I told myself I'd read the whole Bible. And I remember getting to the part in Matthew. where it explained that Jesus died for me. I am 27 years old at this point. I didn't know. I started realizing how lost I really was. So I just simply said to God, I'm sorry. I messed up. And I received Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. And when I did that, this peace came over me that I'm not going to even try to explain it to you. I didn't know where I would be the next day, but I knew what I was going to be aiming for. I was going to be aiming for whatever Jesus wanted me to do. That's really the only thing that mattered.
What shall it profit a man, Jesus said, if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? Suppose he had all the knowledge and all the wealth and all the power in the whole world today and lost your soul. And many of you are doing just that. You gained all that you can gain, but your soul, you're not sure about it. Deep in your heart, something is missing. You don't know what it is. The thing that's missing is that personal relationship with Christ.
So there I was, 19, on tour with Tony Hall. I'm living the American dream, but you know what? I gained everything, but I had no clue about anything in reality. My wife and I, you know, we're making it where there's money coming in, there's more magazine covers, there's more product coming out. But on the inside, there's jealousy, there's trust issues, and things just began to change overnight. And I'm fighting with this woman and calling her names. I would want no one to call my mother. My fists going in the walls, just obnoxious and angry. Within just a year or two of being together, like so many other statistics, we filed for divorce. What's going on in my life? I'm going to just have a life that's sad and hateful. Why am I even living? Does any of this matter if I'm not happy? And I just turned and said to God, whoever you are, if I don't figure this thing out, I don't want to be around anymore. If I don't figure this thing out, I don't want to live anymore.
Too many things that you can live any way you like and get away with it, but you can't. Be sure your sin will find you out. You see, sin is a disease. It's destructive. And we all have it. The Bible says all have sinned. What can we do about it? Come to the cross. We need to repent and turn by faith to Jesus Christ. Let Christ forgive your sins, change your life, turn you in a new direction. You can have peace in your heart right now. You can have peace of mind right now by surrendering your life and your heart to Jesus Christ.
Because of where I was with Tracy, I got into some fights with people. So now I'm arrested, I'm on probation, I have community service, at a Christian thrift store, all these old dusty Bibles, all these funny old smelly clothes. So I go to this Christian thrift store, and oh hey bro, if you want to get some more hours, come across to the church, sit in the service, I'm going to give you extra hours. So what would Brian do? I'm a skateboarder, I haven't got to be anywhere. I drive over there, hung out with all these people, these crazy Christians who love this God that we can't see, and bit by bit, God was dealing with me. And it was that night after church, after being confronted with my sin, that I went home and started praying. I get before the Lord and I say, God, whoever you are, I believe you're the God of the Bible. I believe you're the God that sent your only son to die on the cross, but I don't know any more than that. I can't follow a book. I can't follow a church. I need an encounter with you like you talk about in your scripture that you'll come in and forgive me as I repent. I spent 40 minutes that night on my face before the Lord. It was like I felt the presence of God just show up in that room. I felt the presence of it was here right now. I just felt it. I knew it was real. Everything I ever thought just was gone in an instant. I was forever changed. And the message that was once so foolish of the cross became powerful to me. Fell down on my face and began to weep. And just said, I can't believe this is real. This is insane. I was remarried soon after to the same woman. If I had everything in this world, I'd give it all up to follow Christ. It isn't just that God restored my family, it's that He saved me, transformed me, and that's who He is to me today. He's my Lord and Savior.
All I really wanted was a man who would love me unconditionally. I was willing to do what he wanted. I slept with him. I moved in with him. I gave up my friends. I gave up my family. I gave up everything just to be with him. Then something happened, and it all kind of turned on me. If I would go an hour and a half without texting him, he'd get upset. I wasn't good enough. My opinion about everything wasn't good enough. But things just went from bad to worse. He didn't know why he didn't love me the way that he used to. Why didn't he care about me the way that he used to? Why wasn't I enough the way that I used to be? Being angry wasn't enough. Like, slamming things, I could break everything, and I still wouldn't have the one thing that I wanted, which was his heart. God, I just feel so sad and broken and little. Even though I broke up with him, I realized that, like, I had just made a total mess of my life.
He shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the embodiment of all truth, and I can set you free. Free from your anxieties, free from your troubles and problems. I can give you a peace to go through them. Now, he doesn't take your troubles and problems away, but he gives you a peace and a joy that will enable you to go through them and live through them if you put your trust and your faith in him.
I was so lonely. I felt like I was never going to be enough. I started reading this book about Christianity, about who Jesus was and what he had done for me. I realized that he placed such value on my life. He loved me so much, he put his life on the line. And he really did die for me. And yet, I've been living like I didn't care. It was just like, okay, God, I know I'm a sinner. And I know I need you. And I know I need you to change things now. Because I can't do it. He was everything that I wanted. Except that it was eternal and it was lasting and it was real. And it wasn't going to change tomorrow. He's restored my life. And even my dad. Now he's one of the closest people to me in my life. And I never thought that was possible. Jesus took my life in its darkest moment, in its deepest pit, and he showed me that he loved me and he's willing to die for me. Jesus is the only way. He's the only thing that's deserving of my entire life, and he's worth it.
The scripture says he loves you and he gave himself for you. Must respond by repentance. What is repentance? It means that you're willing to turn over your life to Christ, turn over your life to God, and say, oh God, I need you, I receive you. And then by faith you receive Christ. Have you received him? I'm going to ask you tonight to make sure of your relationship with Christ. You may never again in your whole life have a moment like this tonight. You have no promise of tomorrow. You have no promise that your heart will be feeling the way it feels tonight.
God is speaking to me. Do you know him? Are you sure? You're making a choice between Christ and all that the world has to offer. You're saying, Lord, I'm putting you first from this moment on. Come to Christ.
If you'd like to receive Christ, you can pray a prayer like I did.
Why not pray? Just like this.
Dear God, I'm a sinner.
I'm sorry for my sins. I want to turn from my sins. I believe Jesus Christ is your son.
I believe he died for my sin.
And that you raised him to life. I want to trust him as my savior and follow him as Lord.
From this day forward, forevermore.
Jesus, I put my trust in you.
And I surrender my life to you.
Please come into my life and fill me with your Holy Spirit. And I pray this in the name of Jesus.
And I pray this in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 All is being right. All is being right.
flesh in a weary time. You're the only thing right to left in a world rush. And I want to touch you, but never change in your mind. You're the only thing right to left in a world rush. You see the nation is straight away, but now we're coming back to you, Father. They're calling wrong right, and they're calling right wrong, but you're the only thing right. And I need you, Lord, and I praise your name.
I can't trust in a political system.
Well,
so rough
that it's cold. So cold.
I can't trust
that it's bad.
Well, they can't exist.
You're the only
shit writer.
In a wrong world. In a very wrong world. You're the only thing.
That was the whining. And another whining song is coming up after Mississippi Mass Choir and How Excellent. I like this next song that's coming up. So, this is the whining, only thing right left in the wrong world. Mississippi Mass Choir, How Excellent Is Thy Name, and the whining tomorrow. That would be the perfect song for after the sermon. So, this is the Encouraging Ministries on the Big D Zone. God bless you. I would like to thank Broadsley FM on the Broadsley FM side for listening to the Encourager Ministry, the Gospel Program. And after these messages, after the whining, bridge over troubled waters. And then let the church say amen, and then mercy me on a big D zone.
www.gofundme.com/828DGG. Let me share with you what I am, what I wrote on my page. Hello, I am going to attend Jones County Junior College. I would like to start the summer term. I am going for my AA degree. My orientation is set for May 2nd. I might go on campus, but I can also take online classes and still host my online radio show, The Big D Zone. I have a lot of interest in broadcast and government or political science and education. This will help pay for classes that I take online on campus and books and a meal plan if I plan to go on campus. I also want to put money away in a 529 college savings plan for later semesters and when I transfer to a four-year college after I am done at Jones. Here is the trouble. The college that I transferred from is an out-of-state college. I now live in Mississippi, and I will be charged as an out-of-state student, even though I lived in Mississippi for almost 3 years. Please help me with a donation. I believe in my dream of bettering myself through college, but every year it costs more to get my degree. Make a difference. I thank you so very much. So go to www.gofundme.com/828DGG. My name is Deshaun Porter, Prince Big D. I thank you.
Spoken. So let the church say amen. Lift your hands, God has spoken. So let the church say amen. Oh, thank you, Lord. God has spoken. So let the church say
church.
A day if I have to.
This university, it's not for everybody.
Ever since I was a kid, I wanted to go to school here. And ever since I was a kid, everyone said it couldn't be done. My whole life, people have been telling me what I could do and couldn't do. I've always listened to them, believed in what they said. I don't want to do that anymore.
Okay, Mr. Rudy. Here's the deal. Holy Cross Junior College is nearby. I can get you one semester there. You make grades. You get another semester. Then maybe with a high enough GPA, you might have a chance of getting into Notre Dame.
Thank you.
Congratulations. You are...
I did it.
You did it. I guess. My son's going to Notre Dame.
All right, Ernie, way to go.
2013, writing from my heart. My dear friends, the conditions here get so very difficult that my eyes get blurry, my body does not have the strength to walk, and my steps become very weak and shaky. Various bullying groups, the psychological warfare, almost a year of not seeing my family, physical violence, actions committed to humiliate me, insults, being mocked, being confronted with extremists in the prison who create another prison within the prison walls, and the death threats. It is interesting that because I am a Christian pastor, I am carefully watched. I am expected to smile at them despite what is being done and to understand why they are doing all of these things. But, of course, I can clearly see what is going on because I want to serve God. I see all of these difficulties as golden opportunities and great doors to serve. There are empty containers who are thirsty for a taste of the living water, and we can quench their thirst by giving them Jesus Christ. Maybe you are also in such a situation, so pray and seek God that he would use you and direct you in the pressures and difficulties of your lives. There are those who are enemies of the living Bible and do not want to hear. They are trying to put me under such horrific pressures that are sometimes unbearable, so that they can show me that my faith is empty and not real. And after all of these pressures, after all of the nails they have pressed against my hands and feet, they are only waiting for one thing, for me to deny Christ. But they will never get this from me. This is why the Bible is truth, and they are in the way of destruction. There is another group who does not know the gospel of truth. Instead of truly listening and meditating on God's word, they are just waiting to see how I react to all of their pressures and persecution, what will come out of me during these intense times. But again, this is another golden opportunity for me to shine the light of Christ in this dark world, and to let God use me. Yesterday, when I was singing worship songs, the head of my cell room attacked me in order to stop me from praising, but in response I hugged him. Showed him love. He was shocked. It is during these harsh conditions that I deeply need God's saving grace so that I can be the fragrant scent of Christ in the dark house of Evan Prison. I have often seen the shining morning star in the darkness of this prison, and I have seen his amazing and supernatural works. Oh, how beautiful is seeing the light of the shining morning star of Christ in such evil darkness. So, see your golden opportunities in pressures and difficulties. See the shining morning star in the dark times of your life. I love him. He is gracious, merciful, and righteous to me. I now know that I have not been forgotten, and that we are together in this path. God gives me grace. This is my message for the church. Stay strong for his glory. He will come back soon. Be with God and give your best efforts for his kingdom. Pastor Saeed, servant of Jesus Christ in chains for enduring faithfulness.
Break me down. You won't
get that joy this time around. Can you imagine me in a world, nobody has to live a day because of your love, it's gone away. Can you imagine me letting go of the past?
This truck now. The doctor said I'm gonna start a baby. Family said make the funeral arrangements. Unplugged the machine, he's gone now. Then told my wife to be strong now. Then a small voice said unto me, if you promise, don't stop drinking. I surrendered on that day. And now for 10 years I've been straight.
You saved me.
Oh,
you saved me.
You saved me.
You saved me.
Oh,
you saved me.
Thank you, Jesus.
You saved me.
Oh, no.
You saved me.
Thank you, Jesus.
You saved me.
Oh,
you saved me. You saved me.
Now, I've been sitting in this chair, waiting on the phone to ring, praying up to God that someone would call me with a job opening. Cause it's been so hard for me, month to month, struggling to eat. Still, there was no answer, no answer. I stopped believing in his word and got so mad at him. And when somebody say God's good, I just laugh at him. Oh, feeling it, cause time is blessing for me. Christ graced the phone ring. A lady says we're hiring. That's when I knew
you saved me.
Saved me.
Oh,
you
saved me.
You saved me.
You saved me.
Oh,
you saved me.
Oh,
18 out there on the block selling drugs. With a gun in my waist, and for people I had no love. See, the streets was my home, and family and friends were gone. Had no one to trust, and deep inside I was all alone. And then a deal went bad one day, and it was enough to cause me. I was shot 4 times, and before I knew it, I was on my knees. Pushing up my body, my heart still says, oh, what I'ma do? I don't think I'm gonna last. Then I begin to flash back on the things I've done in my past. No voice that says to me, I'll give you peace if you believe. I accepted Christ that day, hallelujah. Now I'm free to save me. Save me, save me. The grocery store with a pain in my chest, and I'm wondering where did it come from. I got tested and the results came back, and the doctor said, I'm sorry, but you got cancer. I could not believe it, so I called up my mama to calm my nerves. She got down on her knees, she said a prayer for me. So just keep on thanking Jesus, he'll give you all you need. That was 5 years ago. Don't have that pain no more. Doc says you can go home, cause all your cancer's gone.
Said you saved
me.
You saved me.
No, no,
no.
And I'm so glad, I'm so glad, I'm so glad.
You saved me.
You saved me.
You saved me.
Hallelujah.
You saved me.
Oh,
you saved me.
Oh.
Surround me, why'd you have to wait?
And that last song was Switchfoot. We Were Meant to Live here on the Encourager Ministries on the Big D Zone. Well, this has been the first full Honoring God program. And I would like to thank those citizens who have listened to the Big D Zone first full gospel program. I know I usually have it in the middle of my show. but I wanted to give God the whole program, whether it was 2 hours or whether it was 3 hours, and what are songs I could gather, and what are preachers that I could gather, said I Brother Graham. But I want to get more preachers to be featured on the Encouraging Ministry broadcast. So if you're a minister, or a pastor, or even a lay person, and you want to get the word of Christ on the Encouraging Ministry, here's a couple ways you could do it. You could go to my Facebook page, Deshaun.Porter. You could leave a message under the gospel program that you would like to minister on the program. You could also email me, DeshaunPorter1@gmail.com. Again, DeshaunPorter1@gmail.com. And you could also go to the Big D Zone. Now tomorrow, it's going to be the first ever since we moved to this brand new headquarters here at Spreaker Hotel. The first time in a long time of the leaders of tomorrow. Dale Williams, he is the independent contractor for Beautiful Hair, or House of Hair. And he's going to be our guest on the Leaders of Tomorrow segment, the first one ever in the brand new headquarters. So I'm very excited that everything's going to be built up all over again. And I'm going to have another Hall of Fame segment pretty soon. I'm going to be honoring my roommates, and I'm going to be honoring Ernie Abbott, who gave me the motivational audio that you have heard on the Big D Zone. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the home of the greatest fan in the history of the net today. We are Big D Country, and we never give up. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Big D Zone, the Encouraging Ministry, and I am Prince Big D. God bless you. And have a great day and a great evening, and I thank you for listening. Thank you.
is called happiness. Somebody tell you you can't do something. Not even me. Alright? You got a dream, you gotta protect it. People can't do something themselves, they wanna tell you you can't do it. You want something, go get it.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We were all meant to shine as children do. It's not just in some of us, it's in everyone. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others.
What you doing here? Don't you have practice?
Not anymore, I quit.
Oh. Well, since when are you the quitting kind?
I don't know, I just don't see the point anymore.
So you didn't make the dress list. There are greater tragedies in the world.
I wanted to run out of that tunnel for my dad. To prove to everyone that I worked,
what?
That I was somebody.
Oh, you are so full of crap. You're 5 feet nothing. 100 and nothing. And you got hardly a speck of athletic ability. And you hung in with the best college football team in the land for 2 years. And you're also gonna walk out of here with a degree from the University of Notre Dame. In this lifetime, you don't have to prove nothing to nobody except yourself. And after what you've gone through, if you haven't done that by now, it ain't gonna never happen. Now go on back.
I'm sorry I never got you to see your first game with you.
Hell, I've seen too many games in the stadium.
I thought you said you never saw a game.
I've never seen a game from the stands.
You were a player?
I rode the bench for 2 years. Thought I wasn't being played because of my color. I got filled up with a lot of attitude. So I quit. Still not a week goes by, I don't regret it. And I guarantee a week won't go by in your life. You won't regret walking out, letting them get the best of you. You hear me clear enough?
You're gonna give me your best.
I'm gonna give you my best.
All right, one more thing. Don't you do it blindfolded.
Oh, why?
Because I want you to give it up at a certain point when you can go further. Sit down. Jeremy, get on his back. Thank you. Tight hold, Jeremy. All right. Let's go, Brock. Keep your knees off the ground. Just your hands and feet. There you go. Move to the left. Move to the left. There you go. Get the 20. You give me your best. You keep going. That's it. Now, don't stop, Brock. You got more in you than that.
Hey, dude. Just rest for a second.
You got to keep moving. Let's keep moving. Let's go. Don't quit till you got nothing left. There you go. Keep moving. Keep moving. Keep moving, Brock. That's it. You keep driving. Keep your knees off the ground. Keep driving it. Your very best. Your very best. Your very best. Keep moving, Brock. That's it. That's it. That's it. Keep going. Don't quit on me. Keep going. Keep driving it. Keep your knees off the ground. That's it. Your very best. Don't quit on me. Your very best. Keep driving. Keep driving. There you go. There you go. That's it. You keep driving. Keep your knees off the ground. Keep driving it. Don't quit till you got nothing left. Keep moving, Brock. That's it. That's it. That's it. Keep going. I want everything you got. Come on, keep going.
It hurts.
Don't quit on me. Your very best. Keep driving. Keep driving. There you go. There you go.
It's hurting.
I know it's hurting.
But I'm straight.
And you negotiate with your body to find more strength. But don't you give up on me, Brock. You keep going. You hear me? You keep going. You're doing good. You keep going. Do not quit on me. You keep going.
It hurts.
I know it hurts. You keep going. You keep going. It's all hard from here. 30 more steps. You keep going, Brock. Come on. Keep going.
Burn.
And let it burn.
Hours are burning.
It's all hard. You keep going, Brock. Come on. Come on. Keep going. You promised me your best. Your best. Don't stop. Keep going.
Hard.
It's not too hard. You keep going. Come on, Brock. Give me more. Give me more. Keep going. 20 more steps. 20 more. Keep going, Brock. Give me your best. Don't quit.
No.
Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't quit. Brock Kelly, you don't quit. Keep going. Keep going. No, Brock Kelly, you don't quit on me. No, you keep going. You keep going. No, Brock. 10 more steps. 10 more. 10 more. 10 more. Keep going. Don't quit. Give me your heart. You can. You can. 5 more. 5 more. Come on, Brock. Come on. Don't quit. Don't quit. Come on, Brock. 2 more. 1 more.
Mr. Holland had a profound influence on my life, on a lot of lives, I know. And yet I get the feeling that he considers a great part of his own life misspent. Rumor had it he was always working on this symphony of his, and this was going to make him famous, rich, probably both. But Mr. Holland isn't rich, and he isn't famous, at least not outside of our little town. So it might be easy for him to think himself a failure. And he would be wrong, because I think he's achieved a success far beyond riches and fame. Look around you. There is not a life in this room that you have not touched. And each one of us is a better person because of you. We are your symphony, Mr. Holland. We are the melodies and the notes of your opus. And we are the music of your life.